Nice to see you once again. Glory to God. So I thank God for His goodness, for His mercy upon our life, upon His children all over the world. I thank God so much. So, and I want to use this opportunity to say something very important that will be, and I believe it will be a blessing to all of us. It will be a blessing to me and to you and to as many that will hear this. Okay, so my advice to I want to give out now is goes to everybody that the evil in Nigeria, that the evil we are seeing in Nigeria, if you know that it is paining you, that you are truly angry in the inside of you, that you are upset, you are not happy about the evil that we are seeing in Nigeria and in the world, this is for you. I want to talk to you. There's a better way that I want us to follow to tackle it. We need to change our game. We need to change our formation, because I like football. If you are watching football, or maybe you are a lover of football, you can understand that every time a club want to meet, example like Manchester United want to play Arsenal or want to play Chelsea or Liverpool, they always search for a formation that will give them, victory, that will cause them to win. You cannot use one pattern every time. You have to study your opponent and know the formation that you will use to approach your opponent and to win, to beat him hands down. I think the formation that we are using to approach what is going on in Nigeria is okay, but for me, it is not enough. It is not enough, because I have been watching it, I've been viewing it, and I have to talk, I have to say this, I have to say this to everybody to hear. Now we have been talking, we are on social media, talking about the pastors, talking about the killings, talking about the presidents, talking about the whole lying and the stealing and the killing and the deceit that is going on, especially in the church. We have been talking about it on social media. We have been attacking, we've been launching an attack through social media. It's enough, it's okay, but not enough. So why I say it's not enough is that you are talking about them, but they are taking the lead. You are busy talking, you are like, you are eating the leftover, let me put the crumbs that fall from the table. I don't just cool yourself down, I'm coming. You are always waiting for them to do something before you talk. So are you taking the lead, or they are the one taking the lead? Example, I'm coming now. Example, like the one that just happened, launching the highest shrine, calling it a doom. Maybe I call it doom, launching the highest shrine, which I'm not against it. Anybody can do whatever you want to do with your money. You can build anything you want to build. But it's better to say the truth. I don't think that is not necessary. It's not necessary in a country like Nigeria, that a lot of things have gone wrong. A lot of things have gone wrong. It is not necessary. And God does not dwell in a temple made by man, built by man. Our God is so big. The only thing I would not say is that we also need structure. We have to come under to worship God, but not to mount something like what I'm seeing going on. What I'm seeing going in Nigeria is competition. This one build 50 capacity. I will build 100. I will take the ranking from him, the title to be the holder of the highest church. So it's not for the kingdom of God. It's not for the love of God. It's for the selfish purposes. That is what's called competition, not for the interest of the people or for the advancement of the kingdom of God in righteousness, but in competition and in covetousness. That's why I talk, I look into it, I take my time to view some things about what's going on in Nigeria. One will buy private jet, this one will say, okay, I will buy the one that is bigger than the one this one bought. So not thinking of the poor people, not thinking about that the Nigeria is decaying, Nigeria is dead and buried, that Nigeria need to be resurrected, Nigeria need resurrection. They don't think about that. They can come out and tell people the truth about what is going on in Nigeria, or guide them according to the word of God, or give a prophecy that work and say clearly in the word of God. They don't do that. They don't do that. All they want, the after is gambling and doing that. So this is not even what I want to talk about, but I just want to say, I want to give it, use it as an example to what I want to say. So the guy came out now, built the highest church or auditorium. And all of us begin to talk. Whoa, everybody begin to talk. Everybody is charged, you know. Everybody begin to talk. Because it is not bad that you talk. It is good. But also, the motive of your talking, God is also interested in that. God is interested in, you know, the motive of your talking. What makes you to be talking? Because I know that some of us that is even talking, if it happened that maybe we are opportune to have such an amount of money, we may do something like that. I can say it. We can do something like that. You know, you can't justify yourself, or you can't say I'm this and that until maybe you are in that position, in that shoe. Then you do what you do, people will see. That's why the Bible says, let your light so shine before men that they will see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. So the whole world is waiting for me and you when we are in that position. What we are going to do, the mark that you're going to drop. Let us now stop talking now about all these things going on, because they are taking the lead. At least they are making money out of it. They are deceiving people. That's going them is many. Though through what we are doing through the internet, you know, we are opening the eyes of some people, of so many people. They are coming out of their brainwashed state, out of their state. Their eyes is opening. They feel that love truth, that choose to follow God, to walk in righteousness, that love truth. They just feel that here through internet, because so many people doesn't have access to come inside to go come inside YouTube or Facebook or whatever to hear what we are saying. So many people out there in Nigeria, I can tell you that so many people still don't even know what is called a smartphone. Some know, but they don't have money to buy. Progress of coming to internet, coming to buying data to come and listen to what we are saying. So I want to say something. Now is time for everybody. If you know what God has called you to do to help Nigeria, it's high time we stop talking. Let us put it into action. I am called by God to be a preacher. I'm called by God as a revivalist. I am called by God. So my own duty now is I am planning for a revival in Nigeria. I'm planning next year to carry out a revival in Nigeria. I'm just trying to find, I'm looking for the states. I'm looking for the states where I know we will use. And if you love me, you love Nigeria, you love something, love the people of Nigeria to be free, you can join me, you can support me, you can contact me. I am planning this next year to host a great revival in Nigeria. I will be presently in Nigeria, carrying the reviver. Not only sitting down on the internet here talking. I don't believe in that. I said it. I am planning it. I need your help. I need your financial help. I need your spiritual, you know, your backup, your prayer. I need everything. You know, we need each other. If you know anything God have called you to do, it's better you stop talking. Let us start. Let us begin to exercise it now. Enough of sitting down on internet and talking. I was in Galatians where I was invited to my preacher, where I was there. You know, I can be able to tell you that even the persecution that Christians are passing through there is great. But they keep on moving, they're moving on. They are moving on, they are doing it. And I thank God for what he's doing. So we have been talking about all these things. If God have called you to support, to support his kingdom, let us do it. Support financially, you know, spiritually, you know, materially, in every area. If you know what God has called you to do, let us start to do it now. If God has called you to open the eyes of people, you can also step down there and begin to try to create a platform that you can use to open the eyes of the people. The eyes of those that cannot come inside internet to know what you are saying. We can create an awareness through many other means to let them know what God is saying. So this is my advice. Because many of us is talking, it's spending you. You don't like it, but it cannot only be on internet. We need to all go down to Nigeria. We need to plan a revival. We need to plan how to be a blessing to the poor people in that country. We need to move down there and speak to the authorities, to meet with them one-on-one and tell them the truth. And say this is the way it's supposed to be. So as I'm saying to you, you are busy talking. They buy private jet, they give you a job. When they do something, they are giving you work to do. You talk about the private jet, talk. After that, that one will end. And the one will come and build the highest church. Everybody need to talk about that one. You know, we talk. We make subscribers. We shout for subscribers. We shout for likes and dislike and this and that. We talk about it. Write comments and all that. We so much like talking, Africans. We love talkings. We like talking, and we also, you know, like to sit down and talk, you know, gossiping, analyzing the things that's not giving God glory. But in the Westerners, they believe action speaks louder than voice. They begin to move. They may know, see what you are doing at evil. They will not even talk about it. They try to devise a means of stopping you, to stop that evil. They are the one giving you work. The fake pastors giving some of us work. Is what they talk, you pick up and continue talking. They buy jets, you begin to talk about their jets. They buy car, you talk about their car. They build a school, you talk about their school. Why can't we rise up now? Believe God, trust God to overtake them. Let them be behind. Let them be behind. Let us take the lead. They are taking the lead by you talking on whatever thing they do. You wait. Let Suleiman do his own so he can pick it and talk. You wait. You wait for. So it is not the way forward. We need to take the lead, people. We need to take the lead. Enough. How can evil be taking the lead and we are the bad? You talk about it. Like what I said, that you eat a crumb that falls from the table. So how can you be waiting for their mistake for you to talk? How can you be waiting for you to build the highest church for you to talk? How can you be waiting for them to buy the most expensive car or jet or suit or jewelry for you to talk? How can you be waiting for them to buy the most expensive land for you to talk? Why can't we take the lead and show them example? Let them be behind. It's time for us to pray and believe God for us, for heaven, as God has said to me. God said, humble the exalted and exalt the humble. It's time for lost God's children to take the lead. Not these people taking the lead. Right now they are taking the lead. And don't be happy. Stop analyzing and laughing. Devise and let us, as I said to you, anything God has called you to do to help that country, Nigeria, or to help the world, come out now. Bring it out. Come out. Let us trust God. Take the lead. Stop being behind. It is not bad if you come down to Nigeria as God has. You step your feet down there and with the money that God has given to you, the blessing that God has given to you, and they see you doing the good works. It is a glory to God. And they see us host a powerful crusade or revival that will shake the whole nation. After that, every devil and demons died off. I told you, by next year, I'm still watching. If you want to work with me, contact me. I want to host a mighty revival in Nigeria next year. So let us take the lead. Tell somebody, take the lead. Stop being behind. Find another formation. Stop sitting down on internet alone. It's time for action. Let us step down. Let us descend on them like an ego. Let us descend on the devil and the demon physically, spiritually. You know, with everything God has given to us. You know, we need money. We need finances. We need many things to hit that nation. To hit them, to take them from behind and get them down. We need it. So God bless you as you begin to pray. Say, I will not be the one behind. I will stop eating the crumb that falls from the table. I refuse to speak, to talk, to be waiting. I refuse to be waiting for them to do something before I talk. For me to pick from what they did. I need to talk. I need to shout and cry for subscribers and for viewers and for that. Enough of all that. Let's take the lead. Let's do the right thing. I am out now. Tell somebody, get ready for the move of God in Nigeria. Join hands together. You can help in any area. You can help. Contact me and let's do it now. God bless you. God bless you all. God bless all the children of God. God bless the people of Nigeria. And God bless the whole world. We are trusting God for something to happen now. Okay, so see you as you keep on praying for Nigeria, praying for Germany, praying for the whole world. God bless you.